حبيب المصطفى أنت الأمين يا خير خلق الله خير.
وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد. إخواني وأخواتي في الله, my dear brothers and sisters, I have here youth sitting, visiting in the hospital. So alhamdulillah, we're making this special lecture for the youth and for you all, for all of us, inshallah, as a reminder, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. In the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in the hadith in Sahih al-Tirmidhi, لَا تَزُولَ قَدَمَا إِبْنَ آدَمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّهِ حَتَّى يُسْأَلْ عَنْ خَمْسِ عَنْ عُمْرِهِ فِي مَا أَفْنَاهِ وَعَنْ شَبَابِهِ فِي مَا أَبْلَاهِ وَعَنْ مَالِهِ مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَهِ وَفِي مَا أَنْفَقَهِ وَمَاذَا عَمِلَ فِيهِمَ عَلِمْ. There's another hadith, the four, and the hadith أربعة, لا تزول قدم عبد حتى يسأل عن أربعة, but هذا الحديث عن خمسة. Say the hadith, this the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one will step forth and in the day of judgment in the gathering land until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him five questions. In another hadith, 40 questions. But this hadith, عن عمره فيما أفناه, عمره, and his age, his life, how he spent his life. وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه, about his youth, how he spent his youth. وعن ماله, من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه, about his wealth, his money. How he gained the money and how he spent the money. And then, وَمَاذَا عَمِلَ فِيمَا عَلِمْ وَمَاذَا عَمِلَ فِيمَا عَلِمْ, and his knowledge. He learned something and what he have done with his knowledge. This kind of knowledge, what he have done with this kind of knowledge. So this hadith is very scary just to look at it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us very critical questions and we have to have the answer for those questions. We're not going to go further one step until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one, he will ask about your age, your umr, your all your life, how you spend your life, how you spend every second in your life, and his youth, how important the youth is, وعن ماله, and then your money, even in halal way, even if you gain your money bil halal, even if you gain your money with the halal way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you, min ayna iktasabah وَفِيمَا أَنْفَقَهُ, how you gain your money and how you have spent your money. Allah will ask you, because you and whatever you own belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَنْتَ وَمَا تَمْلِكْ لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, أَنْتَ عَبْدٌ لِلَّهِ, you are a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about everything. How you gain the money? كيف اكتسبت هذا المال؟ وَفِيمَا أَنْفَقْتَ هذا المال؟ And how you spend this money, in halal way or haram way. And then وَمَاذَا عَمِلَ فِيمَا عَلِمْ, and his knowledge, you learn a lot of lectures, you get a lot of lectures. What you have done with those lectures? You taught this lecture to the others or you keep this lecture for yourself? And you are a generous or stingy in this, that mean. You're generous when you learn something and you give it to the others. But when you learn something and you don't give it to the other, that's stinginess. You understand, Yusuf? Inshallah. And that's hadith sahih, of course. And then, my dear youth and my brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith sahih, in Sahih al-Bukhari, ni'matan maghbulun fihima kathirun min al-nas, as-sihhatu wal-faraq. Two bounties. Ni'matan, two bounties. A lot of people unaware of these two bounties. Maghbulun fihima kathirun min al-nas, la yadri madha hasal hadhihi al-ni'matayn. نعمتين لا يدروا ماذا حصل ماذا يعمل بهذه النعمتين. So what they don't know what they do with these two ni'mah, two bounties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. الصحة والفراغ. The صحة, that's been the good health. And the فراغ is the free time. And this is really, I have a lecture, I gave this lecture to you before, I think last year, but just about this hadith. About this hadith, الصحة, how important the health. I am in this place, in this hospital right now, and believe it or not, in a lot of time, I cannot even open the Quran, I cannot even read the Quran. And sometimes with the pain, I stutter when I be reading the Quran. I cannot even remember Surah Al-Fatiha when the brains come. Imagine how important the sihha, the good health is. And the faragh, the free time. The free time we spend it in the movie, or spend it playing games, or spend it doing this or that. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold us accountable with that, for that time. That's why in our topic today, say, take advantage of five things. اختنم خمسا قبل خمس. اختنم, say, take advantage of five things before another five things will come to you. اختنم خمسا قبل خمس. And say, اختنم in Arabic language, غنيمة. By the way, غنيمة, it is for the, when you go in the battle, in the battlefield, in the war, like Badr and Uhud, and you get all the bounties. That in Arabic language is غنائم. The bounties called غنائم. Booties, exactly. All those booties you gain, this booties actually from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give it to us. And that is the way only Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had the chance to gain those booties, to take it. غنائم. So, اغتنم خمسا, and Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described these five things like ghanima, like you gain this in with Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has given us these five things. Number one, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس, أول غنيمة هي الشبابك قبل هرمك. Your youth before you become old. Do you understand that, Yusuf? Say so your youth before you become old. وصحتك قبل سقمك, your صحة, your good health before you become sick. Your good health, صحتك قبل سقمك, يعني الصحة قبل المرض, قبل واحد ما يمرض يتعب. Before you become sick and you get very tired all the time. وغناك قبل فقرك, غناك قبل فقرك, your wealth before you become poor. وفراغك قبل شغلك, and this is really important, the free time before you become completely preoccupied with a lot of work. وحياتك قبل موتك, and your life before you die. Your life before you die. And those five things, just to think about it, is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described this thing, ghanima, booties, you gain it. Allah Azza wa Jal give you shabab, give you the youth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the free time, the sihha. The sihha, that means the good health. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the ghina, the wealth. And the Prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the free time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the life. So what you, these five things, how you gain advantage of that things? Because any youth, we gain all that every day. Some people celebrating their birthday, and they should be sad in the birthday, because 1 year passed of your life, what you have done to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this year. Shabab. And then shabab, you become old, for sure you become old. Every single moment in our life, you become older and older and older. As-sihha, there is no way for a person to become, they have a good health all the time. This is sometimes good, you know, getting sick. And this sickness is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَغِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرِكَ, no way for a person to become rich all his life. Maybe some people, some abnormal people, this habit to them, because only the poverty always there. And the فَرَاغِكَ, the free time, not always you have free time. Sooner or later you become very preoccupied. وَحَيَاتَكَ قَبْلَ مَوْتِكَ, every حياة, every person will born, يعني الحياة هي شعار الموت. It means حياة, the life, is the indication of death. As in every person, يولد يجب أن يموت. Every person will be born, it will die. The animals too, the human beings too, the Asian too, the birds too, the insects too. So all of us, we die. We meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sooner or later, subhanallah, رب العالمين. The youth also, Ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه وقال, say, ما أتى الله سبحانه وتعالى عز وجل عبدا علما إلا شابا والخير كله في الشباب. Say the علم, the عبد, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى give the youth the علم. The youth, listen, that is very important. The only the youth, Allah سبحانه وتعالى give the knowledge. Because when you get the knowledge will be stay in your mind, you'll never forget. You understand that? So subhanAllah, but when you get older, like my age, for example, you know, it's not easy to learn things. You're going to teach me the computer, for example. You know, I can, you know, hardly play with the computer, but you can learn it just like this. So the Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, And he says, عبداً عِلْمًا إِلَّا شَابًا. He says, عِلْمُ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى given to the youth. والخير كله في الشباب. And he said, ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى, الخير, all the bounties, all the good things in the youth. سبحان الله. ثم تلا أن he recited the ayat. قالوا سمعنا فتى يذكرهم يقال له إبراهيم. See, we heard a young man called Ibrahim. But you know what Ibrahim عليه السلام, when he went to the temple, what, you know what he did? What he did? Exactly, he dropped all the statues and left, you know. You want to give a lesson to those people. How dare you worship statues, idols, rocks, and you rather to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right or not? So subhanAllah. And then he recited also, إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ وَزِدْنَاهُمْ هُدَى. We are youth, and زِدْنَا هُدَى, that we they believe in the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we increase their guidance. We increase their guidance. And he also recite, وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحُكْمَ صَبِيَّةِ يَحْيَا. Allah Azza wa Jalla made Yahya when he had youth, young, in your age. And he became prophet, Yahya alayhi salam. Yahya alayhi salam. So this is actually an opportunity. This life is a great opportunity to gain the knowledge. This life is a great, great opportunity to gain knowledge as much as you can, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. So, open the door, inshallah. So, thank you. All right. So, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alameen, when we think about this hadith, we think about this hadith, we take advantage of the hadith, so we read a lot. The reading is the most important thing to gain the knowledge of. Now, a lot of people, they have the internet. They use the internet, they read the internet. But you know something, the internet is not everything. The most important thing is not the internet. The most important thing is the books. Books, real books. You know, in my imagination, one day, this internet and the cyber will be virus, and the virus will just destroy all the computers. If the computer is destroyed and there is no internet in the world, what's going to happen? Then you will go back to the books. If you have the books, you go back to the books. If there is no books, then you have no knowledge. Unless if you have the knowledge in your mind, still the knowledge will be forgotten. Even if the knowledge in your heart, your mind memorizing, but you forget, you know, that impossible. The Quran, you recite the Quran every day, memorizing the Quran in your mind. But believe it or not, sometimes you make mistakes. We are a human being, and we make mistakes. We forget sometimes. So it's very important, among the most important thing for the youth, take advantage of the reading. Reading a lot, this is the knowledge. See, now, when we make a standard for the person, so who's that person? That person, he finished bachelor's degree. It's a good bachelor's degree, finished bachelor's degree. Even diploma is good. But when you say the person has a master's degree or a PhD, we honor that person more and more. So according to your knowledge, and a person have no knowledge, never went to school, but that person memorizing the Quran, memorizing the Hadith, memorizing Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, we honor that person. Even he never went to college. You know, some ulama we have in our city right now, they never went to college, but they are muhaddithin. They are really taking and memorizing the Quran, memorizing the 6 books of hadith. We say that muhaddith. When we're memorizing more than 100,000 hadith, we call it muhaddith, right, Yusuf? Right or not? Okay, inshallah. So the reading is the main things we should for the youth. The reading is the only way to increase your knowledge. And we have a lot of examples, of course, in our life from the Sahaba. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he can fit fata. What Ibrahim alayhi salam did? He challenged Namrud ibn Kan'an ibn Kush. Namrud, he is one of the king in Iraq, the area of Iraq and Persia. And he challenged him. He said, you're a god. If you are god, bring the sun from the west if you are able to do that. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Al-Baqarah. If you are Ghazayyab, say, Fati bishams min al-mashriq, min al-maghrib. Fati bishams, bring the sun. And they decide, and Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he was young, he destroyed all those idols. And what he did, and he said, the kabirum hada. See, that idol, the big one, he destroyed all the idols. He know. And what they said, they told Ibrahim, this idol, he's a rock, he cannot do anything. And Ibrahim, exactly this is the point. What he wants those people to go back to their minds, to believe this is a rock, not a god. And then they decide to burn Ibrahim when he was young, youth. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Ibrahim, and imagine this is huge fire. And he's youth, he loved to live. He's young, he loved to live Ibrahim alayhi salam. But subhanallah rabbil alameen, and then they have this great fire. In somebody like in the age of Ibrahim, he'll have afraid because he didn't want to die. And the angel of rain came and said, what do you want? I can send the rain and make this this fire is gone. Or the wind, I will burn all their houses. Or Jibreel alayhi salam to save him, to take him away. But Ibrahim, he said, from you I don't want anything. But from Allah, say, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. That is the statement Ibrahim alayhi salam supposed to say. That was the statement Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved him, saying that they put Ibrahim alayhi salam in the middle of the fire. قال يا الله عز وجل يا نار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم. يا نار, oh fire, be cold and safe upon Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the fire was safe upon Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved Ibrahim alayhi salam. Yahya alayhi salam, when Allah said, Yahya alayhi salam, ayataynahu hukma sabiyya, Yahya alayhi salam, the people of the Israel, they killed, they run after Yahya, and Yahya and his father got killed together. Yahya alayhi salam, Yahya alayhi salam, and his father alayhi salam, Zakariya alayhi salam, they got killed. Just to say the truth, nothing but the truth before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in the youth, we have a lot of, depend on the youth of everything in our life. In our life. You see, Dawood alayhi salam, he was young when he went with his brother, Dawood alayhi salam, and he killed the giant, Jalut. He killed Jalut with what? With a slingshot, and he was young. He was young, subhanAllah Rabbil Alameen. So it is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the most important thing is that because you're always busy with some other things, dunya, materialistic things, you always forget the most important things in life. And that is the salah. And the only things make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the salah. And you cannot delay the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَقُوتًا. The salah in a certain time. The salah in a perfect and certain time. You cannot play with the time in any ways. You cannot play with the time. So with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the salah in this certain time, we have to pray. And the only thing, the salah will make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only thing, the salah will make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say when the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَبْعَةٌ يُضُلُّهُمْ اللَّهُ تَحْتَ ظِلِّ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلِّ. Listen to this hadith. Imagine this hadith. When the sun leaves the orbit, the sun will leave the orbit, and in the top of the people, in the top of the people, and the people will be in the gathering land, swimming in their sweat. People will be in fear. People will be afraid and scared from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah will save some people, some kind of people, some type of people. One of this, شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادِ اللَّهِ. Number one is a young man. Young man, he grow up. A man, a woman, of course. Young man or a young woman, he grow up worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praying on time. And the only way to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you pray on time. When you pray, not delaying the salah, because when, there's no reason make you delay the salah, except if you sleep. Except if you forget, sleep or forget. Say, من نام على صلاة أو نسيها فليصليها عندما يذكرها لا كفارة له إلا ذلك. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you slept over one salah, or if you sleep over one salah, or you forget one salah, you pray when you wake up, or you remember, and there is no penalty other than you pray on time. You pray on time. The salah make you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-salah is a gate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-salah sila ma bayna al-abdu wa bayna al-rabb. As-salah is a connection between the servant of Allah azza wa jal. See, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَبْعَةُ يُظُلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ تَحْتَ ظِلِّ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلِّهِ. I say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, 7 times of people will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that day, there is no shade but the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, شَابٌ, a young man, he grew up worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people. So the only thing is the salah to make you more close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not lose this kind of connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with anything, except if you sleep or you forget. But the class, exam, lecture, this, that will never make you delay the salah. Never make you delay the salah. Always be with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you. Always be with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with all of us, inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our youth and protect our kids and our families, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Jazakum Allah khair, wa barakallah feekum, wa hadana Allah, wa hadakum ajma'een. Ameen.